Then we get to the sad part of the pack, where we have Steen Steinigen and his team, and they have done 183 laps. And but when it got dark, they had trouble seeing the track and had to retire because of the trouble. I don't know if anything was wrong or it's just they didn't practice enough. I don't know, but it was very hard for them, and that's very unfortunate. They had to quit. Then we've seen Team Ezion in their Lola chat doing 103 laps. And the funny part about this is that Team Ezion is only one guy, and that's actually very impressive that he held out for the first 4 hours of this race only by himself. That's very impressive. Lastly, we have the Epsilon Ascari, who has done only 76 laps. But they have had a lot of trouble with their connection, and we have earlier on we had a safety car because of them, but they have all the way through. They've joined each time it was possible, but I think they have gone to bed now. No, but I think they have given up now. But very nice to see them rejoin every time it was possible. So as I can tell, the server is getting ready now, and I'll just find out if you can join with the TV car and have some pictures back. Oh, I think they are getting there now. I think I can see here that both the safety car and the TV car has rejoined, so in a moment we'll be back online. And there we go, we have pictures again. And now we're just waiting for everybody to rejoin the server, and then we can get going. So we're just doing the final preparations, and we'll have the formation lap, and then the race can begin again. And hopefully this is our last server restart, and then we have 3 hours of racing here. This is your 10-man project. You're doing some show for the crowds. But right now we are getting the starting order of the race, and then we will be ready to go to the race session.
Indeed. Everything should be running again now. And considering we have had everything turned off and on again, I think 10 minutes is pretty neat.
Yeah, that's a new record, I believe.
And now we are ready to restart the race. Any particular reason why we are looking at your car all the time, Kasper?
No, I just got into the TV car actually, and the server. But yeah, of course, we all know it's the prettiest one.
It's definitely a good-looking car.
Yeah, Chris has done a good job on the skin, man. Here we have the beauty of the pack, the Team Kitty DK car. Yeah, exactly my words.
When I see it, things start to happen inside my body that it normally doesn't happen.
Actually, I like this the Cowboy Stroop car. I think that's a very nice car.
The 100% electric, the only one in the world 100% electric Corvette C6R.
Yes, and here we have our Team Eastern driver. Yep, I think he has left a moment ago. I think he's just spectating now, but he did a very nice job when he was in here. Doing 4 hours of racing alone.
Yes, and if you take into perspective that he's all new to this, it was actually an even better performance.
Yeah, that's pretty nice. So we see the car stacking up behind the safety car, and we just have another formation that. And then we'll be ready.
And of course, now we've gathered up in line the Formula Yamaha 10-man project and the Team Bernie Racing cars, which are battling very hard, and we know they are pretty much on the same pace. So when the pack's released, it's going to be very exciting to follow those three cars to see what's happening.
Yeah, we've seen last time 2 hours ago that. That Lasse did some very, very fast laps in the beginning of the restart the formation lap, and must say, I couldn't keep up with him. I'm just, I can't keep up with him here in the dark. That's one of his specialties, we know that. And since they are hit with three laps, I think we'll see some very intense racing between Team Bernie Racing and the 10-man project once again.
Yes, it's going to be exciting how fast Lasse is. I think you're right. I think that Lasse is perhaps to racing in the dark what Michael Schumacher and maybe Fernando Alonso is to racing in the wets. He's very good at it.
Yeah, indeed. We saw that at the 24-hour event in Collingwood earlier on this year, last year actually, where he did some very, very neat laps and stints in the night. And I think that's similar to what we are experiencing here today. So we are ready for takeoff, and after this last big happen, the safety car will pull into the pits at the right, and the race is off. And here's green track, and
go!
And they're going.
And also, we have to remember that the FTC car is only one lap behind the Team Kitty DK car, so if he can get by now, he's actually not a lap behind anymore.
No, that's going to be very, very exciting. Because we have seen the young drivers of the Team Kitty car, the upcoming stars, as we call them, but they've been a little bit unstable. Whereas the quite seasoned drivers of the FTC car has just powered on and stayed in the race all the time.
Well, FTC is definitely attacking them now.
I think the gap is a little bit too big at the moment.
Even so, he is looking up at the inside in every turn.
Well, as expected, the gap has already risen a bit to Lasse in the former Yamaha. He's powering on where he as he just left the car. But I think Timber Project is hanging in there. Oh, at wide there.
Well, it's a funny car that is the storm, because it's. It feels like it handles to us like it's two cars in one. There's a more relaxed, more leaned back endurance car in there, and then if you give the car some more revs and power, use more power and use more engine wear, it's a very good sprint car.
Yeah, I had a go in it a couple of days ago. I had to just test, look at the fuel economy and so, and I must say it's a very nice car to drive. The only problem is that you're sitting in the wrong side.
Yeah, you're sitting in the wrong side, so all of a sudden, and not just a little bit to the wrong side, you're sitting all up to the door in the wrong side.
Yeah, leaned up against the window almost.
I'm told that it is that way because they wanted better weight distribution, so they had to pull that huge 7-liter Jaguar V12 engine as far back as possible. So the middle of the engine is actually right below the lower starting of the windshield. so the engine is actually pulled back very far. And of course, as it is with the Corvette, the gearbox is moved from being attached directly to the engine to be placed directly in front of the rear differential.
Quite surprisingly, the Team Bernie car isn't going as fast as we had expected, and isn't putting up a fight with the 10-man project, prison the 10-man project car at the moment. Actually, he's lapped by the Jim Cullen car, although not lapped, overtaken. Oh, not quite. That's a pretty intense battle right there. As mentioned earlier, these cars are two of the hardest cars to overtake if you're driving a car like the Ford TT or the Lister Storm, because they are so fast in the straights. Therefore, you can't. It's hard to pass them on these narrow twists and turns in this track, and then on the straights, they just open up the gas and they go so fast. That's very hard to overtake these cars, but that's similar for these two, so it's a very, very interesting fight, this. That's a very neat overtake, I think, from the Team Cullen Racer 3. Let's just have another look at these two, because if you just take a look, they are driving very similar lap times right now, and that's not because they're going slow. Less on the Lister, in the Lister Storm, the former Yamaha just did a 154.553. And Chris in the 10-man project for GT, he just did a lap of 154.550. That's very, very close, Wilson.
I think that maybe the weather's colder now.
I'm just looking at the track temperature, and it's 37.6 or 8 degrees, I think. So no, it's quite similar to before. I just think they're just pushing each other a lot. in front of the pack, you can see that the team, the FTC said, Razor has overtaken the Team Kithia. This means they're actually on the same lap now, with a quite huge gap, but the trailing FTC has actually actually won for the moment, and it's going very fast. It just put it the new fastest lap since the restart.
So this must mean that the FTC car is no longer left behind, right?
I think you're right, Peter.
It still is left behind, but it's no longer two laps behind.
Oh, yeah. Sorry, my mistake. Yes.
So he is trying to catch up, and once he catches up on this lap, he'll still be 1.0 laps behind.
Yeah.
Well, if that's the case, it's up to Team Kitty Cat to lose it right now, because he's used the last 3 hours to catch up with a single lap, and he's not been able to get more than one lap. So either he needs more server restarts, or he needs Team Kitty DK to do something bad.
Yeah, you're right. We have seen the young drivers of the team, and the inexperienced drivers of Team Kitty. They go very, very fast, but not that that steady, and has had a lot of spin-out and crashes and so.
Yeah, a bit of a joke. They really make things interesting, that's for sure. But nevertheless, worthy winner if they can pull it off.
Yeah, I think they have been going very, very fast.
My money's on Team Kitty.
And they even doubled as a safety car earlier when the safety car had gotten a... and also the streaming car had gotten disconnects. They actually did a good job of driving a safety car. That's a new one.
That's my money is on Team Kitty. They're going to win the LMP class. I definitely think so.
Yeah, I think you're right, Peter. And the lesser than the Formula Yamaha has just done a 154.321, and I'm sitting here talking to Chris, and he's struggling to keep up, and then he just thought, yes, I get it, I got a lap faster than Peter, because Chris just did a lap of 154.5, but Les just went even faster. That's incredible how they're pushing into him in front.
I'm just sitting here looking at lap times and wondering, how did FTC get past Team Kitty DK, because they are driving very similar lap times. Sometimes FTC is faster, sometimes Team Kitty is faster.
Yeah, but I think that's because of this instability. Maybe they've made a little mistake or something like that. We have seen them have quite a lot of spin-out.
Yes, that would make sense to the Team Kitty drivers. Perhaps got a little bit nervous when the FTC car was looking up the inside in every possible turn.
Yeah, even a seasoned driver can get some sweat out there.
Yes, it's it's pretty hard to focus on your own lines when you suddenly see a pair of shining xenon lights in your side window.
Yeah, indeed. And the team curling race is actually going faster than team burning right now, but because of some unfortunate crashes and so on, they are 7 laps behind, no, 6 laps behind now, team burning. So they has a lot of work to do to catch up, and I don't think that will be possible. They're just racing till then now to finish.
Yes, I was talking with Alex about this just before I had my last stint. We were talking about distances between cars compared between the two classes. You know, one lap between two LMP cars is a relatively shorter distance or shorter time than one lap in a GT car. And when you add the factor that the LMP cars are much more fragile than the GT cars, then the gap is actually even smaller, because when one of these guys in the LMP cars make any mistakes, it's going to cost them more damage, and it's more likely for them to have to do a pit stop.
Yeah, you will get punished right away, whereas in the GT cars you actually have a chance to do some damage control.
What I actually heard from the Team Cutting Free boss, Ben Juul, was that for the first, I think, 3 server restarts, they had to hit in and fuel during the safety car period, which is just incredibly unlucky for that to happen 3 times in a row. That accounts for, I think, most of the laps that they are behind, because they have been going very fast, so I think at least 3 of those 6 laps, if not more, would be because of just really bad luck strategy-wise. And of course they have had a few crashes as well, which without those they would be looking very good.
Yeah, but again, that's the spirit and the toughness of endurance races as we practice them. It's you can't just restart and you can't just join again after 20 laps, so that's...
what was that? The FTC car went off the road because he had too fast an exit, and here we saw exactly what you were talking about, Casper, the inexperience of the Team Kitty drivers, who was just following him like a dog in a leash, so he took the outside line and went into the kitty litter too.
Yeah.
I'm not sure that it takes experience to do that. It's quite easy once you get into the groove in a long endurance race. If you're closely chasing someone and they make a mistake, it's really hard not to copy the mistake, I find, especially at night.
Yeah, at night definitely makes it easier to copy a mistake.
But yeah, you just
in general, I find that when you get to a point where you really break from things beside the track instead of looking at the tracks and looking at the cars in front of you, you'll do this much less than you do when you're focusing on the car in front.
Yeah,
that's true. Yeah,
the best way is to get some fixed points and some marks around the track where you these won't change. In a race like this,
yes.
It's not a good idea to say, okay, I'll break at this shadow, because when it gets night, there's no shadow anymore, and you'll have a hard time finding the right line through a corner, because now it's dark and you have no fixed points.
Yes, but I also find that this tactic of finding things beside the track sometimes tend to have you focus too little on the car in front of you, so that when you are in a close battle, and you know where you have to brake, and you brake at that usual point, and the car in front of you just brakes half a meter or a meter before that, you can actually end up in some pretty hairy situations. Because when you know your absolutely latest breaking point, and you break there, and the car in front of you breaks a meter before, you can't brake any harder. So where he goes, you have to try and turn around or avoid hitting the car in front because you're going too fast in.
Yeah, that's right. You have to pay attention to all our drivers.
Some of these cars, it's actually a little hard to see the braking lights. On the Audi here in the daytime, it's no problem to see the braking lights because both end plates of the rear spoiler light up like Christmas trees. But in the night, the rear plates are lit up all the time. So I think it's actually pretty hard to see when that car's braking. You can see it here. Just. It just goes from a thin light to a slightly wider light. It's actually pretty hard to see.
Yeah, you actually have to pay attention at the moment of the change of the light, or else you won't notice it.
No, that's exactly right.
If you just blink for a moment, then you won't see it.
Whereas the brake lights on the Corvette is something completely different. You will know when that car's braking.
Until they light up your whole windscreen.
Yeah. I would imagine in real life that would be quite annoying to drive behind that, because every time he's pushing the brake pedal, the whole world gets red around you.
Yeah, you'll have to close your eyes, but then you can't see the traffic either. So let's just have a look at some other brake lights. This is the Ferrari 550. That's very clear because it's a whole new set of lights that light up. It's very new, actually.
Yeah, that's well thought of.
Yeah, and it must be in everybody's interest that you, the other cars can see that you brake so that they don't end up in the back of you.
Yes, and especially in cars like sports cars, where you have cars with very, very different properties and different classes. It's actually, I think, pretty... perhaps one of the most important things, light-wise, to have very visible brake lights.
Yeah, it's fine. I don't know if you can see it, but actually here at the back of the Ford GT, it says not driving fast, just flying low.
That's a good slogan.
Yeah, that's well thought of. Again, by our master artist, Chris, of the 10-man project.
At the 24, our race, the DTR 24, we had a message on the rear of the car too that said, "Lights on, please." Because we noticed before that it was really hard to see the LMP cars coming to overtake, and the speed differences on the Le Mans track between the GTs and the LMPs is quite a lot larger than it is here. So for us it was really important that other cars were using their lights when they were coming.
Yeah, but I think ours is inspired by the sticker in the cockpit of your car at the 24-hour event in Köln.
Oh, the sign that says "Don't fuck up."
Yeah, exactly.
We have that here too. We fucked up anyway.
Yeah, you did. Maybe you have to think of a new stigma.
Was it from Jan Magnussen we got that idea?
Yes, or they the Corvette guys, they always used to have funny things in their car, and I think some of the bars in the roll cage had stickers on them that said don't fuck up. But they also have many other things like teddy bears and stuff racing with them. Actually, I think somewhere on YouTube there's a video of one of the Corvette drivers that's actually having some sort of two teddy bears and actually enacting a small play when he's going when he's going down the straight in front of the onboard camera.
That seems a little bit dangerous, but fun nonetheless.
Yeah, if I can just interrupt you, it seems that Team Kitty has had another incident of some kind. They are trailing the pack right now. And they've just a lap of 3 minutes and 55 seconds.
So, while we had our focus on nonsense
and
quite meaningless stickers and rear lights, there was actually something interesting going on.
Yeah, but we missed that. We should use that as a heads up, I think. This means that the FCC has another good chance to catch up with the Team Kitty.
I think I'm going to double bet right now.
Yeah, maybe you sold that too soon. They're actually on the same lap now. No, wait.
3 minutes, that, 9 seconds wrong. Behind.
Yeah, that must be 1.5 lap. Ish.
Lasse is sitting right there beside me, and he's quite furious because he can't make the car go fast enough. He wants a fastest GT lap time.
Yeah, but anyone remember what guy it is that has done the fastest GT lap time?
I don't know. Why don't you tell us?
Yeah, maybe it's implied, but I did that. Actually, I think it was very funny because it was the same stint as Lasse was in the car earlier, and he beat my previous best lap time. And Chris in the pit told me that, and that annoyed me a bit, and then I just had to do better. Just like Lasse is a bit annoyed right now.
Well, I'm quite happy with it being this way, because I know this keeps Lasse focused.
Yeah, that's a good idea.
So, actually, for him to try and take the fastest lap is actually taking less of a risk than is if he was just cruising.
Okay, that's a good point here.
It all comes back to what I was talking about with Alex about racing. It's as much a mind game as it is on coordination and physical prowess, or what you say.
Yeah,
because of course in real life you have to be a very very fit person to drive these cars, and the cars we have here corner like they were on rails. And they often pull between 2 and 2.5 G's in the corners, and that's actually enough so that you can't breathe when you're sitting in the car in a real life GT1 car when you're turning. Of course, we don't have that issue here.
Well, one or two more of these stunts by the Team Kitty car, then it's gonna be quite interesting in the LMP.
Timing says that FTC is only 1 minute 20.5 seconds behind.
Yeah, that's interesting. At the moment we have 2 hours and 22 minutes left of racing. nothing is sighted yet. I think that the Formula Yamaha is looking quite strong, and I think already now we can expect it to take the first place.
Yes, if we don't have any more problems, as we are one of the last cars left on track to be able to cause a safety car, we actually
could have
a computer crash or something like that. But as we are playing on the same network as the actual game server is on, I think we may have a slight advantage there.
Well, that's nice to hear. That's a bit of an excuse for us. Yeah, that's an embarrassment.
Yes, but as I was talking with our pit crew we actually don't think that it's the connection to the server. We are very much accusing the lobby structure of GTR2 of these issues, because while you are racing, you are still connected to the lobby, and if you lose connection to the lobby while racing, then you will be disconnected from the server too. So even though you have a good connection to the server, you'll still be disconnected.
And this has always been an issue, and it's very, very annoying.
Yes, and that of course is the same for us, even though we are on the same network as a server. So we still have to maintain connection to the lobby.
Yeah, that's right.
It's a very unfair thing, because it always hits some specific people, like because of their internet connection or router or whatever, they have a disposition for this to happen. So for some of us it almost never happens, and for others it just happens in every race. So it's really unfair.
Yeah, I think we've been very unfortunate this time, because usually I don't get disconnects from the races in GTL here, where I'm sitting now on my 5 of connection, but unfortunately this happened today. And that's just bad luck, and you can't do anything about it.
And it's actually, if we take mind, take into account what the positions were behind before you lost your internet connection, you were actually exactly 2 laps ahead of us in the Formula Yamaha car, and now you are 3 laps behind.
Yeah, and as we lost connection, I counted and I think we lost about 3 laps in the safety car period, and before the restart took effect.
Yes, and then of course if you disconnect, you get a lap in penalty, so that's an extra lap.
I think everyone who disconnected today got lost at least 3 laps on that account. Because it takes the time from them to make the race controller aware that there needs to be a safety car period, and a safety car to get out and collect the field, and the guys to get ready to connect again, and so on. So really, in total, you will always lose at least 3 laps doing it.
Yes, but what's interesting is that we picked up 1 lap, so that when we restarted the race, you were 2 laps behind us, and now 3. So if we go back to the positions before that safety car, we will actually be on the same lap right now.
Yeah, and exactly that where I was going. It could be have been very, very interesting racing. But unfortunately, that isn't the quick case right now.
No, and I'm weird in that way, I know, because I would have wanted it that way, because that would have been so much better racing. But of course, I'm happy as the positions are right now, but in any case, it's of course we won't give up any laps or surrender, but it's actually much more fun when it's close racing.
Yeah, I agree on the account. With that said, you must be very pleased, Peter, to get this win for your DTTL championship points.
Yes, on DDGL championship, this is awesome sauce on my position.
Yeah, that's been looking quite bad for you the last couple of weeks, right?
Yes, normally I drive the Viper, and it's not, as soon as it turns, it's a bad car. When it's straight, it's a good car. I expect somewhat of a comeback on the last Spa track. That's a 3-hour race too, so I'll have an hour more to put in fast lap times.
To do some magic.
Yes, and I know the car is very, very fast on the straight, and that is able to make up for the lack of speed on the rest of the track. And also, the version that we will be driving is the one with the early revised bus stop chicane. So that's a 2004 version, and that has some slow corners, second gear, first gear corners, and accelerating out of those corners is one of the major strong sides or benefits of racing the Viper. It has acceleration like nothing else.
Yeah, it's no secret that right now it's look like the digital championship will be between Peter and myself. It all comes down to the Spa event. Actually, it looks like right now if you look at the remaining races and then calculate the expected points.
Yes,
it's going to
be
very exciting.
Be excited before the last race. I don't think so. It's going to be interesting to see how well I can do at the Laguna Seca track. I'm hoping that the back straight, the going up the hill, can be an advantage for the Viper 2.
Yeah, I think the Viper.
But there's a lot of fast corners on that track, and that's no good.
No, I totally agree. But if the back upgoing uphill straight is so significant in this track, and we saw it on Benoit 2 that when we were going uphill, you had it grow very, very fast. The rest of the track wasn't for the driver on Benoit at all.
No, because it turns all the time.
Yeah, that's right. But I think if you look at it and at the Laguna Seca, this uphill back straight is a very dominating big part of this track.
Yes, well, enough about the coming GTL races. Of course, that series is open too, and everyone can join by connecting to our website on GTL.dk or visiting the Danish Grand Touring League Facebook group.
Yeah, let's rejoin our race here tonight. On first place, we have the FTC car, but that's not the truth. That's since the restart. So the Team Kitty car is still in the lead, but not by much. By 1 minute and 25 seconds, actually. Then we have the FTC in the second place, and this is all our LMP cars we have left. In third place, we have the Formula Yamaha, and it looks still going strong with the Lasse behind the wheel, and still putting in very fast lap times. And from where I'm sitting, I can see that the lap times of the Ford GT has gone a little down. So I don't think we can do anything about it. Actually,
there is a three lap gap. Down to
and all those
10 man all project.
Those, yeah. But what is interesting is the team Bani Racing that is currently running third place in Fuji and is in the same lap as the Ford GT.
So they're trying to keep up with you and battle for the second place.
Yeah.
Yes, second place in the GT class, and that is actually the battle of the LMP cars, the two LMP cars, and this is actually the only two battles, if you want to call it like that, on the track at the moment. But still, if we think there is just, what are we down to now, 2 hours and a quarter of an hour left. 2 hours, 10 minutes left, so we are more than 10 hours into, or perhaps just 10 hours into the race, and there are still cars fighting for the lead in LMP class and podium places in the C class.
Yeah, I must just correct myself. Actually, the Team Bernie Racing, I think it pitted in a while ago, so now they are one lap behind if you look at the live timing. But I can reveal that not just a couple of laps for GT will do their pit stop too.
In a not so distant future.
That's right. And then I think I'll have to leave you for an hour or two, and I'll do my last stints.
Well, and of course, about two or three laps after you pit, then Lasse will pit, and then I will have to leave you too.
Yeah, then we'll have a chance of commentating crew. Well, to go on, the Team Crying Racing is currently running fourth in the GT class, and they were up fighting for the top three in the beginning of the race. They have had a lot of unfortunate crashes and spin-outs, and therefore they're just finishing now. They are 7 laps behind, I think.
I actually think that I will be leaving you here, and I will grab a bite to eat before I have to drive. It's been really wonderful talking to you here and commentating the race.
Good luck on your last stint, Peter.
Good luck on your last stint, Peter.
Yes, you guys are the best commentating team in the whole world.
And the best spectators.
Well, good luck to you too, Casper, and thanks, Alex, for the race control. That's been really good, and we couldn't have done it without your help.
You're welcome. And I think I can proudly say that I'm the only driver who drove without any mistake. No damage on the safety car so far.
No, I did it too.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, but to wrap up all this sentimental stuff, I'll just go have a look at our the last car. We have the Cowboy Strong, and these Germans used to race rally, both in real life and sim racing. So that's a change of pace. But they're powering on, and they are not very experienced in the endurance racing and setting up of cars, but they just like the driving, and therefore they just keep on going. It's very remarkable, I think.
Yeah, and I've seen them improve a lot over this since the last time I saw them drive as well. I think they are getting a lot better every time they drive with the rest of the pack. I think they came from driving mostly against AI drivers, so of course the competition is quite different when it's real sim racers you're driving against, and especially when they are as experienced as some of these guys. But they're really picking up, and they have a great spirit, a great team spirit, and they just want to have fun and want to make sure it's a good event for everybody and so on. So yeah, it's really wonderful having them here. Kind of a shame that Bernie Racing seems to have lost some of the steam they had earlier going against you, Casper, and Chris in the 10-man project car. It was really, really close for a while, and it looked like it might be a very long battle, but I guess the setup of the Ferrari isn't quite as good as your 4 GT setup, probably.
No, maybe you're right about that. I'm looking forward to seeing the recap here after the race of Meistern. I know that they are placed in the sim race TV with sign afterwards. The replays, and I look forward to seeing that stint, actually, my own stint, because I had enough to do touring the car, so I didn't get a good look of the racing at that point.
There's actually a SimRace TV YouTube playlist, which you can find on the SimRace TV Facebook page, and they have put up hourly updates, so you can probably see the battle between 10 Man Project and Bernie Racing right now if you wanted to, but of course we have to follow the rest of the race first.
Yeah, we'll just wrap up the last 2 hours here.
Yeah, and then it maybe definitely isn't over yet. There's a lot of room for overtaking still. We have a couple of close things. I mean, 10 Man and Bernie, they're still within a lap or two.
LMDs are closing in on each other.
Yeah, they're a minute and a half apart, so still things can happen in both classes, so it is nowhere near over.
No, that's right. And here we see Bernie pitting in. And Chris is pitting in 1.5 left from now, and that means I'll leave you to it, and I will go do my last stints now.
You better get ready, Kasper. Good luck on your last stint.
Yeah, thank you, and good luck with controlling the rest of the race.
Thank you. Hopefully the safety car can be retired now. For now, we will have to do with looking at the Bernie Racing team. I don't have capability to change the camera, but I think in a few minutes we will have that capability. In the meanwhile, I'll keep a rest.